We can upload log files in either Surety or Surety Pro. However, Surety is limited to having one log file at a time, while we can upload unlimited log files into Surety Pro. For this demonstration, we are going to use Surety Pro. However, the principles we will discuss can be applied to Surety as well. In Surety Pro, you can upload log files with or without a client selected. I am going to upload the log without the client selected. To upload log files, hover your cursor over File, Import, As Applied Logs, and click on either Satlock Log or TrackMap Log. We are going to choose Satlock Log. The Upload Satlock Log dialog will open, of which the Upload Log File radio button will be selected for you by default. Here we have the option to choose to upload either individual log files, or you can choose to upload a zip file, which will usually contain multiple log files. Additionally, the checkbox for Select and Zoom to Uploaded Log is auto-enabled for you. When this is enabled, then the map will auto-zoom to the map extent to display all of the field or fields that have a log layer. Moreover, the spray path for the log layer will auto-enable too. Let's start by uploading individual log files with the Select and Zoom to Upload Log enabled. First, click on the Browse button and Explorer will open for you. Locate the file on your computer. We can either double left click with the mouse or single left click and click on the Open button to make your selection. I am going to double left click with the mouse. You will return to the Upload Satlock Log dialog. Click on the Upload button, of which we will receive confirmation that the log file has uploaded successfully. Click on the X to close the confirmation message. Click on the Close button to close the Upload Satlock Log dialog. The information contained within the log file has been applied geospatially to the mapping system, of which Surety or Surety Pro will then auto-zoom to the extent that displays the field with the spray path layer auto-enabled. Now on the right-hand navigation, we can see our map layers. Also, because the right-hand navigation can change dynamically, if you do not see your map layers, then click on the Layers button in the right-hand navigation to display the map layers. Locate log layers. Click on the plus symbol to expand the log layers that are available. The date, time, and file name of the log will be displayed. Just to the right are three tools that we can hover our cursor over and see what action it can do. Finally, you can choose to enable or disable the log layers that you desire. Also note that in order for logs to appear under the log layers, they must be within the map extent. From this point, I can generate the FSA map, for example, and our log layer will be on the image. Next, if I were to choose a client in Surety Pro, then our map has reset to the map extent for saved borders, which happens to be within range of where the log file is. To quickly zoom to the field with the log layer, I can click on the Zoom To tool for that log. If I use the aerial form or perhaps a custom form for my work order process and I have one saved, then I can open the Forms Manager, click on the form or work order to open it that I would like to apply the log to. Then click on the drop-down to choose the log layer for that as applied, and we will see the date of application, start time, end time, and the acres applied auto-populate, as well as the map image will dynamically update to display your chosen log layer. Finally, when I save the changes to this form, this log file will be available to this specific crop year in Surety Pro.